The United States government will not pay ransom, will not give in to demand. Do we think it is a bad idea if another government does exactly that?
I can tell you that this is a long-standing policy that predates this administration, and it's also one that we've communicated to our friends and allies across the world.
But how is what the Jordanians are talking about doing any different than what the United States did to get the release of Bergdahl, releasing prisoners held at Guantanamo Bay to the Taliban, which is clearly a terrorist organization?
Sure. As you know, this was highly discussed at the time, and prisoner swaps are a traditional end-of-conflict interaction that happens. As the war in Afghanistan wound down, we felt like it was the appropriate thing to do. The president's bedrock commitment as commander-in-chief is to leave no man or woman behind. That's the principle he was operating under. Well, I'd also point out that the Taliban is an armed insurgency. ISIL is a terrorist group. So we don't make concessions to terrorist groups.
Feel the Taliban is a terrorist group?
I don't think that the Taliban... the Taliban is an armed insurgency. This was the winding down of the war in Afghanistan, and that's why this arrangement was dealt. Our view is, as the president said at the time, which is, as commander-in-chief, when he sends men and women into armed combat, he doesn't want to leave anyone behind. That was the commitment he was following through on this.